In this video, I will show you how you can add a JIRA Service Desk database and import JIRA data into Power BI using the BI connector from Invantive Cloud. You do not need any technical knowledge to use our connector. This tutorial works for both PowerBI.com and Microsoft Power BI Desktop. Don't have an account on Invantive Cloud yet? Then watch our video on how to create an account for a free 180-day trial. Press the Add Database button on the homepage of Invantive Cloud. Now select the Atlassian group from the list of platforms. Click on JIRA Service Desk. Allow the Power BI connector for JIRA to access your Atlassian account so you can link your data. Also select the desired JIRA site. Your IP address must be added so that you can use Bridge Online with Power BI. Click the orange Add and Save button. Now launch Microsoft Power BI Desktop. Select Get Data under the Home tab in Power BI. Look for the standard O Data Feed connector in the list of Power BI connectors. Click on Connect. Now go back to Invantive Cloud. Click the copy icon next to Bridge Online URL. Paste the copied URL into the window in Power BI. Click on OK. You must now log in with your Invantive Cloud credentials. Click on Basic. Enter your Invantive Cloud email address and password. Then press Connect. Expand the list of JIRA tables. Here you can select your JIRA Service Desk tables with the data you want to use in Microsoft Power BI. When you've made your selection, click on Load. Depending on the size of the JIRA tables, this may take some time. After the download into Power BI is complete, you will see an overview of all your tables on the right. You can check a table to use for dashboards and reports in Power BI. If there are any changes to your JIRA Service Desk database, you can click on Refresh at the top. This will refresh the data in your Power BI dashboard and reports and includes the latest changes. You can now use your JIRA Service Desk database in Power BI. If you want to use a different Power BI connector, you can find more videos on our YouTube channel showing you how to use the other connectors.